that's the case, that's not going to be an easy extraction because it's not possible to gasp it. It's just on the line of the gum and it looks like there's a rotten root.
Yeah, I understand. The rotten root was causing this. Hmm. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, so this will need x-rays.
Yep.
To have a better look, a better idea of what and how bad, and if, because probably the root is several pieces, so that's a bit of a major surgery. No, don't turn your head. Don't move. Well, there's a huge inflammation in that area.
Okay, so now we're going to do... So what will the wire do?
It will tell me on the x-ray which tooth or where the area of where the infection is coming from.
Okay.
Okay, right. The x-ray shows that actually the wire goes in this direction, so that means that the affected tooth is his last molar.
Yes.
Okay, and when you perform the surgery, you have to come from below the tooth and push it up to bring it inside the mouth. The problem is that this last tooth has got a lot of bone because the jaw is wider at this area, so the surgical access is a bit more difficult because having it pushed out, pushing in this direction is going to be a lot more difficult than if you go straight under the tooth.
I understand.
So that complicates it a bit, but we will see how we can do it.
Okay, so are we going to do it here in house?
I'm not sure yet.
Hospital?
The fact that the tract of this is curved makes it more likely for it to go to hospital, because if it was a straight tract, for me it's fairly easy to go just in the same tract where the infection is sitting and just making it wider, a bit bigger, to get my instrument through and push it through. But
I
have to follow a curved pattern, it's going to be a lot more difficult.
Okay.
I'm not sure if I actually want to drill a new hole, so I need to look into it and see what would be the best way forward for him, and take it from there. Really.
How imminent do we need to do this?
Well, I think it has been there for quite a while, so I would like to have a better condition, a better body condition to him to go through the sedation. The problem is that it can be a longer procedure, so he needs to be sedated for quite a while, and if they are weak, you can have troubles with the sedation, so I would probably delay it a little bit, not overly long, but a little bit, and in the meantime, I would cover him with antibiotics to stop the infection from spreading anywhere else.
Okay, Dorothea, thank you for that.